हेलो। हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू? हेलो हेलो,
यस सर।
यू सी माय मोबाइल? इज मोबाइल कैमरा इज विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू? हेलो
यस
हेलो,
सर।
ओके ओके। सर
So this is the panel of to study the V and inverted V curve of synchronous motor. Shaptarshi sir, please diagram in the manual and explain it to the students.
Okay. So this is the circuit diagram of the V. Hello. Is my mobile camera visible to all of you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is there any issue with sound? Hello. Hello. Is my voice is audible to all of you? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is the circuit diagram of the V card. Okay. So today we will going to design this circuit on our experimental panel board. Okay, in the given circuit you can clearly see that a three phase AC supply is there. A three phase AC supply is there. A three phase AC supply is going to the stator, because in the synchronous machine armature is in the stator side. So three phase AC supply is going to the stator through the power factor meter and Dall starter. Okay, through the power factor meter and Dall starter, three phase AC supply is going to the three phase induction motor stator. Okay, and in the field of the synchronous machine, we will going to excite the field of the synchronous machine with a variable DC supply. So for that reason, we separately give a separately DC excitation to the field of the synchronous machine here. Okay, so in this circuit diagram, two different supply is there. One supply is three phase AC supply. It is going to the armature, that is the stator of the synchronous machine, and DC supply, it is going to the field of the synchronous machine. Okay, that is the circuit diagram. And in the when the three phase AC supply is going to the synchronous machine armature, it is going through the Dall starter and power factor meter. And in the series, we connect a ammeter so that we can see the armature current of the synchronous machine, and the voltmeter is also connected in the parallel. And one ammeter we will also added in the in this circuit, in this field excitation circuit, so that we can see the field current of the synchronous machine. Okay,
so basically here what we will do, we will start the machine as an induction motor, then we will provide supply to the field of the synchronous machine, and the machine will act then as synchronous motor, because the field will be locked and the speed of the machine will be locked to the synchronous speed. Okay, you will study this, that what are the different methods of starting of a synchronous motor. It will be explained clearly in your theory class. So in today's experiment, we will measure the field current. For that thing, we have an ammeter connected in series with the field, and we have to measure the armature current. That's why we have an ammeter connected with the connected in series with the armature. Okay, now please explain.
Okay, sir. So after that, we should design this circuit on our given experimental panel. So as Nirmalu sir already said that in the experimental panel, you can clearly see one RPM meter is there. That is for using the RPM meter, we can see the speed of the synchronous machine. Okay. Now after that, one voltmeter is there, parallelly connected. Okay. Parallelly connected with the three-phase AC supply. Here one ammeter is there. It is the DC ammeter. It is connected in the series of the excitation circuit, and one also ammeter is there for see the we can using this ammeter we can clearly see the armature current. Okay, and here you can see behind the below the meter you can clearly see this is a supply for three phase AC supply for MCB, and below that doll starter is there for the starting the machine. Okay, and it is clearly seen in the synchronous machine. It is rating. You can clearly see the ampere is 3.8 ampere. Okay, and voltage is 415 volt. Okay. Okay. So in the circuit diagram, sir, if you clearly see in the circuit diagram, is there any problem? Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, please admit Pranav Kumar there, sir. Sir, he is waiting.
Doctor, sir, somebody is waiting.
Okay, so now we design this circuit on our given experimental panel. First, you can clearly see first three phase AC supply. Okay, here three phase AC supply is there. You can clearly see three phase RYB three phase supply is there. 420 volt is supply is there. We can start this supply through this doll starter. Okay. The output of the doll starter, you can clearly see the output of the doll starter is going to the input of the power factor meter. You can clearly see the output. This is the output of the doll starter RYB. It is going to the input of the power factor meter. The output of the doll starter is in the input in the power factor meter. Okay. Output of the doll starter is going to input in the power factor meter, and the output of the power factor meter is going to the three phase induction machine. Okay. So here it is the output of the power factor meter. It is going to the three phase induction machine. Okay, it is going phase to the three phase induction machine. If you can clearly see the output of the RYB red, yellow, blue connection is going to the input of the three phase induction machine. It is basically phase the armature of the synchronous machine. Okay, and you can clearly see in between the parallelly we are connecting a voltmeter in between from the doll starter supply. We connect a voltmeter parallelly. You can clearly see this voltmeter we are connecting from the supply through. Okay, this is we are see the voltage. Okay, three phase voltage. Okay, now after it is going to the three-phase supply. Now it is output of the power factor meter is going to the three-phase synchronous machine. So three-phase power supply circuit, this portion circuit is completed. Now we are coming to the excitation field circuit. So in the excitation field circuit, you are see that is the DC supply. You can clearly see these two terminal, positive and negative. These two are DC supply. This is the variac for the DC supply. Here we using this variac, we can increase the voltage 0 to 220 volt. Okay, excitation voltage is maximum 220 volt. You already see it is in the rating plate. Okay, so it is the supply here. DC supply is there. DC supply is going to through ammeter. DC supply is going through ammeter. It is going to the excitation field. So DC supply is going to through the ammeter. It is going to the stationary field for excitation. This is the excitation field, and the other terminal is connected there. Okay. So that is the part of the synchronous machine field excitation circuit. This is the part. Okay. Now after we already designed this circuit, after the designing, what we can do? We can first start the synchronous machine. First of all, what we can do, we start the synchronous machine. Okay, so we give the supply. So first, what we can do, we just on the supply of the three phase, we can on the three phase supply here. Okay. One second. So first, we start the synchronous machine as the induction motor. So that's why we are first give the supply. We first give the supply. Okay, three-phase supply. So three-phase supply is on. Now we should start the synchronous machine as the induction motor. Okay, and also there one important point is that now field is open. Field when we supply the three-phase DC supply and start the Dall starter, then the field should be open. Okay, you can clearly see one knob is there. It is the open circuited. Okay, now we should on the synchronous machine using the three-phase DC supply as the induction motor. You can clearly see motor is running. Okay. After that, what we should do? We should close the field circuit. We close the excitation field circuit, and now the synchronous machine run in the synchronous field. Okay. Now after that condition, we can clearly see now the armature. The field current is 0.0. You can clearly see field current is 0.0 and armature current is 3.5. So in the diagram, you can clearly see field current is at its minimum position and armature current it is maximum position. That's why it is showing 3.5 ampere and it is showing 0.2 ampere. And the speed of the motor is 1500 RPM. And the three-phase supply is 412 volt. Okay. After that, what we should do? We should increase the DC excitation to this variac. We should increase the DC excitation. When we increase the DC excitation, we clearly see if I increase the DC excitation here, we can clearly see DC field current is increasing. Field current is increasing. You can clearly see field current is increasing.
You can clearly see field current is increasing 0.1, 0.2, you can clearly see. And armature current is decreasing. So we note down the whole thing. When we increase the field excitation, then field current is increasing and the armature current is decreasing till we find this point, this unity power factor point. After this point, when you increase the field current, then armature current is also increasing. So we note down this thing because we need to draw this curve. Okay. Okay, so first we increase the, first of all, we increase the field excitation first in the starting point. So in the starting point, what we should do? We should first note the starting reading. The first reading field current is 0.014 ampere and armature current is 3.14 ampere. Okay. Now we slowly increase the field current and measure the reading of the armature current. So we should take the reading on 0.1. Okay. So 0.1, when the field current is the 0.1, then the armature current is 2.5. Okay. And now we increase the field current 0.2. Okay. I adjust the field current 0.2. Okay. 0.2 and armature current is the, you can clearly see armature current 1.97. So armature current is 1.97. Now if we further increase the field current 0.2, okay. Field current is 0.2 and armature current is 1.42. Now after this 0.4. Okay, we should take the reading 0.35. So 0.35, the armature current is 1.78. Okay, after that, we should increase the field acceleration 0.4. Field current is 0.4 and armature current, how much? 1.97. If we increase further, field current 0.5 ampere. We set the field current 0.5 ampere. And the armature current is 2.5. Okay. After that, if you increase the field current, one thing we should remember, that is the maximum, we can vary this maximum value 3.8 ampere, because the rated current is 3.8 ampere. After beyond 3.8 ampere, we cannot vary this current. Okay. So if we set the 0.55. The armature current is 2.9, 3.0. It will also further increase. Okay, so okay, that is our reading. We should also talk on the okay.
Okay, so here you can clearly see it is when we are increase the field current, when we increase the field current of the synchronous machine, then armature current is decreasing after here it is decreasing after this point when we increase the field current, then armature current is increasing. Here it is increasing. You can clearly see 1.78, 1.97, 2.5, 3.0. Okay, so we can clearly plot the graph. Okay, armature current versus field current. Okay, we can easily, using this data, we can easily draw this curve, armature current versus field current. So in the next day, we should upload this manual in your Google Classroom. You should carefully draw this curve. Okay, draw this. Please take the screenshot of this data. And draw the curve with the experimental manual. So thank you for today. If you have any doubt or query, you can ask in the Google Classroom. We should definitely come back to you. Okay. Okay, thank you everyone.